What's up, runners? Alexandra from the Run Experience here. I started running back in January of 2021, and I have accumulated quite the collection of running gear since. But today I want to talk about the essential gear that beginner runners need that won't break the bank. So first, let's talk about running shoes. Running shoes can cost anywhere from $50 upwards to $200, and that is a huge range. So when you are first starting out, when you are seeing if running is your thing, what I would suggest is take a look in your closet. Do you have a pair of sneakers that you wear on long walks or even to theme parks? And are they comfortable? And if the answer is yes, then those are the shoes that I would suggest that you start to run in. I did the same thing when I first started running, and I ran in those shoes for about 2 months before investing in a pair of running shoes. Next up, of course, are running clothes. You do not have to spend a lot of money on running clothes. As long as you have something that is comfortable and that you can move in, that's all you need to get started running. That being said, if you feel like you want to go out and buy a super cool new running outfit because you're gonna feel good in it and that's gonna make you feel confident, then I am all for that, and I 100% support feeling good in what you're running in. And sometimes that's just fun. Thing on our essential running gear list is a water bottle, specifically a water bottle that is easy to carry. Now, this might seem obvious, but as a beginner runner, you are putting your body through a lot of new things. As we build our running stamina, we want to keep our heart rate low and we want to feel in control of our runs. And having water to stay hydrated will help us tremendously. This will make our runs more enjoyable, which in the long run will make you stick to running and create a healthy habit with running. As your body gets used to running, you'll be able to leave your water bottle behind for some of your runs. But while you're a beginner, it is a good idea to have it and not need it than not have it and end up needing it. The fourth and final thing on our list is some kind of pouch or running vest to carry your phone, your keys, your water, a snack, all of those things, and it's very helpful. Personally, I tried a couple of different things, including just sticking my phone in the waistband of my shorts. I found though that a running specific fanny pack or a running vest was really the most helpful because it didn't move around while I was running, it didn't bounce, and it really just didn't feel like I was wearing something extra. While a waistband is certainly the cheaper option, I highly suggest a running vest. This will carry your water, your food, your phone, your keys, and all of those things. And it also adds another benefit in that it's a little bit heavier. And so as you're getting used to running, you're carrying more weight. So when you ditch that vest, you feel lighter and it can help boost your runs and your confidence when you're racing. Like I said, running gear does not have to be super expensive. Chances are you have most of this gear in your closet at home already. And once you gather these four items, all that's left to do is start running. If you are interested in earning your miles with the Run Experience, we have an awesome first 3-run challenge that is in our app just for you. Once you have completed your first 3 runs with the Run Experience, all you have to do is post a screenshot of each session in the community tab in our app, and a coach will personally reach out to you with a profile badge and an exclusive link for a 30-day free trial of our app and 50% off our monthly subscription. The link to join us in the Run Experience app is down below, and let me know in the comments what inspired you to start running.